I didn't go vegan for the animals or, you know, the environment or anything. It was just purely lost my leg, infection, climbing up, chopped my leg more and more. And my girlfriend ran in and said, I've cured myself of breast cancer. And I was like, how did you do that? And she said, I've gone vegan. And I was like, vegan schmegan? What is that? You know, being a northerner, well, I like my sausage and mash. And but they were going to take my knee off, so I went, right, I'll do anything. She took me over to America, Florida, Hippocrates, West Palm Beach, shoved me with all that wheatgrass juice that I brought over to show Lorraine and Dr. Hillary. And I was healed in 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
And I was raw vegan for 2 years, but that's really difficult and a boring life.
So in those 2 weeks, what changes did you notice?
Well, they did blood tests. They were filling me with so much antibiotic in the hospital that I just became antibiotic resistant. Mm. And my whole... because my stomach was swollen like mad because I'd crushed my pelvis as well, punctured my lung and split my head. And I just noticed immediately all the gas, all the bloat go down. The digestive issues I had, you know, you get severe constipation, diarrhea, all sorts of problems when that area is disturbed. And my energy came back and I was just, it was just incredible.
Excuse me, just on that subject, I want to talk about bowel movements just specifically while you're there.
Lovely.
No, but it's true. Heather says here somewhere, I'm just noticing, you said something like, people think it's okay to go to the loo once a day.
And it's not. Where I, if you think of dogs, right, you feed your dog and you quickly get your dog out. Dogs have a lot of hydrochloric acid down here. So when we're young, we have a lot of it. And then as we get older, it gets less and less. So people get acid reflux all the time and they don't actually think, well, why am I getting acid reflux? But they're throwing loads of things in that are just fermenting. And then they're shoving Gaviscon and PPIs and all that. And all that is putting a lid on a volcano. And then the second it runs out, you've got to take another one, and that sort of depletes your whole immune system.
Do you think we should be going to the loo more often?
You need to go to the loo after, within an hour after every meal. That's when you know it's working properly.
And if you have a vegan diet, does that happen naturally?
It will, because you have a lot of fibre. But it's important, when you've had so much meat in your system for so long, it's very putrefied. It stays in there for a long, long time. So it's best to slowly... It's good to become a flexitarian to start with, so slowly reduce down. And then our products like V-Bites and others, they basically replace like for like. So you can see in the Daily Mirror the recipes that Eamon's looking at.
I'm looking at your recipes.
You can have a chicken korma. Yeah. It's vegan chicken. You can have a beef stroganoff.
What does vegan mean? I think people know vegetarian, what vegetarian means.
It just means anything plant-based. So anything that's not from an animal. So it's just literally, we make things taste like meat, chorizo, pizzas, cheeses, you know, coconut-based, pea protein-based. We got more protein in our products than, you know, our fish, for example, is in the fish digs in all the green pubs, fish and chips around England now, has more protein than normal fish. And people always used to say, well, where'd you get your protein from? And I said, well, I have muscles, so I obviously get it from somewhere. So it's just replacing like for like. You know, we got Bill Clinton to go vegan. He's off all his medication now for 7 years.
I mean, we have to be careful, obviously, of telling people that you can cure yourself of breast cancer or cure
We don't make that statement. Yeah. But you literally... I fed 4,000 kids for 4 years in the Bronx and donated $1 million worth of food. And we saw type 2 diabetes gone in 3 months. And this is with... Professor Colin Campbell, scientist.
Problem, isn't it, with young people here.
Big problem with acne is dairy. So you've got quinoa milk, oat milk, rice milk. So if you replace like for like, you're not missing out on anything. I would always suggest a B12 supplement. But when you're a carnivore, you need all sorts of extra.
Why do you need
things.
A B12 supplement?
Because you get that mainly from meat.
Yeah.
And but when you actually look at what carnivores need and general eaters, they're missing out on all sorts of vitamins and minerals.
What do you think is the major problem with the Western diet now? Is it sugar?
Sugar, fat, you know, meat's proven now, scientifically undisputable, that when we were kids, you know, as a northerner, we didn't have much money and we had meat once a week, twice a week if we're lucky. Your body can handle that. But
well,
now,
there's a health warning today. There's a health warning today that no amount of alcohol, sausage or bacon is safe, according to a new global blueprint on how to beat cancer. No amount.
I'm sure it's not, but people want to live a life. Mm. So that's why we've done burger for burger, chicken for chicken, chorizo for chorizo. It's no good unless you're really, really sick going over to a raw vegan diet, because you're not going to stick to it. It's like any kind of diet means life.
If you're interested...
Yeah, just replace like for like. And then, on the science that we did with the kids, because Jamie Oliver went to America and he tried to get everyone to do vegetables, and that was a great idea. But you can't take a kid who's lived off McDonald's straight onto vegetables. You have to replace like for like. Then scientifically, their metabolism, their taste buds change. And then you
I think it'll be harder to wean a 58-year-old man off his tastes.
No,
I was going to say.
Which looks wonderful. You have to bring me out to dinner. You've got to convert me.
I'll cook for you and you'll be shocked.
Well, it's amazing. It's also fantastic, the jobs you're creating in the Northeast with your V-Bites company.
Well, that's why I'm pleading with the supermarkets to start buying British. You know, we've got Brexit. We're in this sort of situation, love it or hate it. The manufacturers are leaving for Germany, left, right and centre. And I go back to my hometown. I'm about to build a factory in Austria. And I find out my friends lost their job. So I bought the Walker's Crisp factory. And then we bring all the jobs back again.
How amazing is that?
So buy British.
Yeah.
Well, 25 years on from that first interview, you are looking really well as well. Interesting. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much indeed.